Hello everybody, welcome to today's session. And here we are going to see the partial order planning. This is another important question in third unit. In the previous video we have seen different types of state space search, and here we are going to see the partial order planning. In the university examination you can expect any one of these two questions under 10 marks in the first part of third unit. Before entering into partial order planning, we should know what is the total order planning. All the state space searches, that is the forward state space search and the backward state space searches, are forms of totally ordered planned search. It explores only strictly linear sequence of actions which are directly connected to start or goal. And this total ordered planning cannot take advantage of problem decomposition. Decomposition means splitting the big problem into small subproblems and solve the subproblems individually. The partial order planning is otherwise called as PAP. It works on several subgoals independently, that is, in problem decomposition, the solution of subproblems are subgoals, solves the subgoals with subplans, then combine all the subplans. Based on the requirement, the subplans may be reordered, and there is no fixed commitment, and delaying is also allowed here. The actions may be unordered, or otherwise they must be sequential. PAP example: putting on a pair of shoes. We have already seen this example in the class itself. There are four objects: left socks, left shoe, right socks, right shoe. So there are four actions automatically. Before that, there are two states. First one is initial state and second one is goal state. Initial state is nothing, that is barefoot, and goal state is right shoe on and left shoe on. And there are four actions. First action, right shoe on. So for right shoe on, the precondition is right socks on, and the effect is right shoe on. That is, after the actions the effect will be right shoe on. And second one is action right socks. The precondition is none, that is barefoot. So on the barefoot we are going to apply this action right socks. The effect is right socks on. And simultaneously action left shoe and action left socks. In the partial order planning, we have to include two dummy states. First one is start and second one is finish. And there is no precondition for start, but for finish state, the precondition should satisfy the goal state. When come to total order planning, there is no fixed sequence for solving. And here there are six different total order plans. But when come to partial order planning, the difficulties are reduced. And in between start and finish there are two sequence. First one is left socks left shoe and right socks and right shoe. The order may be changed based on our requirement. How to define partial order plan? Here a set of actions which make up the steps of the plan, a set of ordering constraints A less than B. Here A and B are actions and less than symbol represent before. So we have to read A before B. And next, a set of causal links, that is A achieves P for B, that is right socks will execute before right shoe. The precondition of right shoe is right socks on. And next one, a set of open preconditions. A precondition is open if it is not achieved by some actions in the plan. The initial plan for our example. So first we need to plan for start and finish actions. The initial plan contains first start, the precondition is none, and effect is add all propositions that are initially true. And for finish, the precondition is goal state and effect is none. And ordering constraints: the start should come before finish, that is start before finish. The causal links are nothing. And open preconditions, the precondition of finish, that is the Precollision of finish is both the left shoe on and right shoe on. And next to the successor function. Arbitrarily picks one open precondition on an action B and generate a successor plan for every possible consistent way of choosing an action A that achieves P. The consistency: a casual link action A achieves P precondition for the action B and the ordering constraints are added. Here, action A before action B and action start before action A and action A start before finish. And resolve conflict: add action B before action C or action C before action A. The goal test: there are no open preconditions for the goal test. The final plan: the final plan has the following components. First one is actions, and there are six actions here: right socks, right shoe, left socks, left shoe, start and finish. The orderings of actions: right socks before right shoe and left socks before left shoe. Open preconditions are nothing, and links: right socks achieves right socks on for right shoe, left socks achieves left socks on for left shoe, right shoe achieves right shoe on for finish, and left shoe achieves left shoe on for finish action. And example algorithm for POP: it is a sound and complete partial adder planner using STRIPS representation. The function POP contains three inputs: initial, goal and operators, which returns plan. Plan is nothing but make minimal plan of initial and goal function, and loop starts if we got the solution of plan, then return the plan. Otherwise, select the sub goal of plan which assign to the step need, and C is the precondition of step S need. Choose operator of plan comma operator comma S need comma C. Here operators are nothing but the actions. S need is next step. Resolve threads of plan and end. And that's all about partial ladder planning. Now the question time. Define partial ladder planning. This is simply a 2-mark questions. And students, please answer the question in the comment box. Thank you, all of you.